Kapısından alacağım. Evet. Tamam.
Lang Cathedral, as you can see. When Shah Abbas, the king of Safavid, chose Isfahan as the capital city, and he wanted to make this city a multicultural, multi-religious city. So one of his plans was to also have the Christians, which were for us, the Christians are Armenian, because Armenians are known among the first people accepting the religion of Christianity and respecting Jesus. So he moved a big group of Armenian from northwest of Iran, an area which is called Julfa, all the way down to Isfahan, and then he chose this area, which is the southern part of the river Zayandarud, which in the old days and even now is almost one of the best parts of the city. And then he said, this is your land, you can make your homes, stay here and just feel at home. And then they called this area also as Julfa, because where they were coming from, that area was called Julfa, so they called this area as Julfa as well. So when they were here, they started making their churches. We have more than one churches of Armenian, rather smaller one. This is the biggest one, the main one, and also the most beautiful one as well, which actually has got a museum here. And as you can see the dates over there, that church was started in 1606, early 17th century, and 1655, the whole place was completed. Like the bell tower, the dome, and all things related to Christianity. There, you can see stars on the wall. Some say that is this the Star of David. If you notice, you see it's not, just because of the direction. They've got two sides up rather than one side up. The stars that over there. But if you just turn it a little bit that way, that becomes like the Star of David. But they just put it the other way around, which is different from the Star of David. For Iranian people, we Iranian people consider Armenian people as very nice, lovely people, easygoing, and very, very respectful people. They are also known as honest people as well. And they did great things. They also made the first publishing machine here. They had papers and published everything. They have their own alphabets, as you can see on the top of that church. Those alphabets are something that we cannot read. They have their own language. Originally, Armenian come from the land which is called Armanistan, which from old days, back to thousands of years ago, was part of the Persian Empire. So what we say in Armenia, in our language, we call it Armanistan. So they have their own language, which is completely different from Persian. They also have their own, characters and alphabet as well. The statue that you saw outside was the man who made that printing machine. We have a memorial site here. This is for 1915 genocide, which was done by the Turkish against the Armenian. The Ottomans moved all the way from the western side to clear off the whole land out of all, you know, other, you know, ethnic groups and religious people. So they killed many, many Armenians. They do not want to accept that that was a genocide, but because Armenians were not actually, first of all, were not prepared, second, they weren't actually didn't agree to fight with the Turkish, they just attacked and destroyed everything, killed people, took these kids and, you know, women as hostage. Many of them were already dead. And then when you go to the museum, you can see this, you know, beautiful, you know, collection of the pictures and documents about this genocide. Nowadays, the Armenians are trying very much to convince the United Nations, the countries over there, to force Turkey to accept the genocide. But the Turkish do not accept. They say this was a war and we didn't actually commit any crime, no genocide. Second, if they do accept and apologize for that, they have to pay a lot of money, and they also they have to lose some lands because they also occupied their land back that time. Now Armenia is a very small country. Even in Turkey, we have Armenian people in those areas, which they went back there a few years later, and then now they're called as Turkish people, but originally they're Armenian and they're Christians. So this is actually the memorial you can see, and there are also alphabets down there, which are all in Armenian. Let's go inside and under the main dome and see this beautiful painting inside, some more explanation inside, please. Oh, by the way, an Armenian are the followers of Krikorian. Probably your name was Krikorian. You changed it into Krikorian.
No.
Well,
that's
you can explain
right.
more.
That's another story.
That's another story, okay. We would love to hear your stories. As you can see from the sign here, the Church of Saint Joseph of Arimathea. Saint Joseph was known as one of the disciples who brought the body of Jesus down the cross. So actually they call all these great things after his name. And in Armenian language, which the name is mentioned here, Sor Amenaprich, which is very difficult to say, and Vank. So shortly we call it Vank Cathedral. Okay, inside please. Okay, inside please. And inside please, turn off the flash of your cameras and mobile phones.